Right, everyone, look. Look, that's the first time I've seen that in this with modern one. Now, there isn't a bull. If there is, he's not up here. He's further down, but it's not cow time. So it's unlikely the bull will be out if the cows aren't out. Now, it looks to me like you can get down through a track there down to Wookie as well. Look, see there's a trail leading down there? But this is why I am doing this walk today. Partly because of that and wild cows. And at least it's warning you. That's the first time I've seen a warning sign. A modern one. Not an old one that's faded on some fence. Now somebody turned back a minute ago. I bet they seen that. Thought, oh, I ain't going in there. So it does put you off. It doesn't mean you can't walk through a field with a bull in it. Well, I'm glad I'm doing that this time of year. Because if this had been the summer, no way would I have gone in there. That's why that person backed off, I reckon. They backed off, just like I would. Well, I'm glad they're telling people at last. Maybe someone's been listening to my videos. I've got to look out for the gate that takes me to back through the farm. If I decide to do that route. Which will be better than ending up on a road. Yes, it's a new sign. They're using blue ones now that stick out better. Here we go, look. West Mendip Way. So when I come back out, after I've been around, there's Ebbor Gorge there, there's the wood. Rather than go another way, here's a type of stile look that you can climb over. So I'll be going across there to that farm there. Now I've just come, although I did a big circumference surrounding the farm to get a good idea of the land. Glastonbury Abbey, Wells, where the big cathedral is. And I came through right at the top from that field over there, where there's a sign warning you of a bull. Now it could be that the bull could be out down there. But normally they take cows. I mean, a bull ain't much different to a cow. Well, it is, but it still can experience problems in the mushy wetness. So I expect they've taken them all into the farm. So here we are. We're up on the beautiful pure air above Priddy. Opposite the Glastonbury Tor, which is on sentry duty. And I've been here before. I've been there before, and I've gone down. I think I went down over there to a gate. I'm glad they've put some more signs up. See, there's public footpath, but of course, okay, is that a sign of a cow? Not now, that's old cow. Well, what I'm saying is, at least they're warning the public now. Because people think, when they see public footpaths, they think that they're protected, they won't be hurt. You know, but no. So here I am in the beautiful countryside, everyone. I met a woman on a horse earlier who pointed out that little route back there for me. It's just after 12 o'clock now, so I've got a good 6 hours or more before it gets dark. And I'm looking for the entrance to Ebbor Gorge. I'm at the top of it. And I'm glad I've done it this way round, because believe me, it's very steep. But I'm sure I'm going to have to do some climbing at some point. And it could be that I'll be coming back this way to go down to that farm. That is very, very likely. But for now, I'm going to wander around inside the gorge. I brought my other camera for videoing, and I can charge this one up properly. I've decided to bring out the charger and two cameras, but remembering that the black camera is no good on Zoom for pictures. It's right, Zoom for video though. Strange, isn't it? It needs something doing to it. I did drop it on the floor, so I expect something just got dislodged. We'll be coming up to a plaque in a minute, so I'll keep the camera rolling for a minute. It's all very mushy and mushy. Glad I wore my boots. It's all very mushy, 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 mushy. Oh, looks like they put a new sign up since I was here last. Of course, when you come up, when you get to this point, I have to come up the gorge. You'd be cows here waiting for you. So, I never used to be scared. I've said it a thousand times, but when you've been chased, everything changes. Right, humpy, bumpy ground here. Probably a settlement up here at one point. That looks like a perfect place for a settlement, doesn't it? This little copse here. There's Ebbor Gorge. I'm going to go down through there in a minute. But we just go up over humpy, bumpy ground. Yeah, this is where there could have been a settlement up here. Could have been Roman. Could have been the miners that looked for the lead up here. Yeah, it's a typical humpy bumpiness. Right then. There are designated pathways within Ebbor Gorge, by the way. This is also a better time of year to come. You can see more without all the leaves, but of course it's very, very beautiful when it is green. But with that you get ticks, I'm afraid, and you get limes. The ticks up here have got Lyme disease. What will they give it to you? I'm not saying every single one, and there's also very, very large horseflies as well. Very large horseflies here. David John Clark. Let's see if I can just... I go out of focus sometimes. When I put the viewfinder away, it sometimes moves the little needle. So I'm having trouble focusing at the moment. It really annoys me when that happens, you know, because it puts everything out of focus and you have to edit that bit out. I'm just going to have to focus on this badge. Wait a minute. It's a very skinny little needle. You really have to be very careful. See how it's gone out of focus already? No, it's too far that way. It's like tuning the sights on your gun. Too far that way. That looks all right. Now we should be able to see David John Clark on there. 1961 to 2014. A thoroughly nice man. Well, he would have been 57 this year then. Right then, over here we've got Ebbor Gorge. You are here, it says. And I'll be going down. I'm not going to go down. I'm not going to wander too far. I'm just going to do the main bits. That's the plan. Yeah. important woodland that lie on the south escarpment of the Mendip Hills. The woodland is mainly ash oak, but other native trees include whitebeam, witch elm and field maple. In spring, many typical woodland plants can be seen, including bluebell, wood anemone, violet and yellow archangel. The reserve has some amazing geological interest, including a number of small caves where the remains of Ice Age mammals and evidence of later use by Stone and Bronze Age man have been found. Like I said, I've got other videos. I haven't videoed up here much though, this bit. Not for 2 years at least, 2 to 3 years. I have been all up here, I mean I was exploring. And believe me, I remember climbing up from the bottom and I'll probably end up doing some climbing later. I won't get away with it. There will be some climbing that needs to be done. But of course, coming this time of year as well, without all the ferns and bramble, you can see a lot more evidence of other things. For example, so if you have a guide or someone who knows this place very well, they can point out all these features. For example, this looks like a sheep dip or something, doesn't it? See, I've never noticed this before because all this has been cleared. And you can see, I've seen these. I've seen these over near Ebbor Gorge. These areas, whether they're sheep dips or just, there's something definite, aren't they? The way they've been built and structured. And that looks like a very old stone there. Yeah, so this is a feature. I will look this up to get more information about this. But it looks like they have tried to clean it out as well. It's part of the history of the place. And like I said, because they've cleared, the volunteers, whoever they are, that come up here to protect and preserve exposed stuff for us like that. And then if you've got a group of kids or students, you can get them to find that and, you know, read about it and things like that. Just seen a little dunnock coming out of there a minute ago. A little tiny dunnock. Taking a risk, mate. They might set fire on it. Yeah, it's smaller than a sparrow, a dunnock. It's a really, really cute little bird, and you just wonder how it can survive. It's so tiny. Yeah, so it could be that because I came in the summer the last times I've come before, spring and summer. It's not quite spring yet, but there will be hungry ticks that have been denied a winter or been asleep. So if I get bitten today, I won't be surprised. The sun's out. Here's a warm human body coming along. I've been bitten before, and I think I've had to suffer from it. But when your immune system's strong, you can usually fight it off. It's when you're down that you have the problems, really. How you get older. They're crafty little creatures and all. They get on you and you don't feel them until they bite later on. And then you don't always feel them. I'm just doing a bit of an extensive video for people so that it's not just a snippets here and there. You can actually see a consistent walk in many ways. Little birds tweeting. I expect you get adders in it up here and all. There will be snakes and grass snakes and lots of different plants and little creatures living under stones and stuff. But I know where I'm going, but I need to divert slightly in the beginning because I want to get to this platform where you can see right over the gorge. And with it being less green, there'll be a lot more to see. But I don't want to get lost because I can remember that there are various pathways that you can follow. So it's a case of me remembering which ones. Right, so West Mendip Way, yeah, this is part of the famous West Mendip Way. I talk about a lot, and I do part of this walk all over Somerset. Like that, see? Livestock warning. Abide by the country code. Keep dogs on leads and close gates behind you. Like I say, it's quiet this time of year. It is quiet because, but it won't be for long. I mean, if it continues to be mild, they'll let them out earlier, you see. So here we go. We're entering the gorge now, for sure. And in a minute, there'll be a slight diversion where you can go and look over a huge... Well, you can look down through this huge gap, you know. It's quite warm now. I'm going to take my hat and scarf off in a minute. It's quite warm now. So, I've only seen two people since I left Alberta. The car, the van. One woman on a horse. And one walker who decided not to enter the bull field, which I was walking through. At the same time, you know, if you know the area and you know what the farmers are up to, you know that they will be taking the cows in for a certain period of time. It's also to let the grass recover, by the way. You know, because they eat a lot of grass. So basically, when the grass starts to grow and continue to grow,